Board.
Tom?
Tom Fox, member of the board.
Charlie?
Charlie Jones, alternate member of the board.
Bill?
Bill Haas, member of the board.
Phil Rabina, member of the board. Steve?
Steve Price, solicitor to the board.
Emily?
Emily Diaz Melendez for the zoning office.
Okay, thank you. Just before we get started, there is an appeal 2403-0005, which is 1116 Perry Street. They have requested a continuance, and I am going to make a motion to grant that. I make a motion to grant 1116 Perry Street a continuance till next month. Do I hear a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Opposed? Okay. All right. Now we have some decisions from last month's meeting. Appeal 2402-0003, and that's 1220 Center Avenue. Mr. Price.
Is there a motion to approve the relief requested subject to the conditions set forth in the written decision?
I'll make the motion.
There's a motion and a second. Are there questions or comments on the motion? Hearing none, all in favor, say aye.
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 Aye. Aye.
All opposed? Ayes have it.
Okay. The next appeal was 2402. It was 00041 Berkshire Place. Mr. Price.
Is there a motion to approve the relief requested subject to the conditions in the written approval?
I'll make the motion.
There's a motion. Is there a second?
Second.
There's a second. Are there any questions or comments on the motion? Hearing none, all in favor, say aye.
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 All opposed? Ayes have it.
I think that'll be a great addition to our city, though, and bring some new jobs. I think that'll be a good project.
Yep.
Now, we have some continued cases. Appeal 2024-01, 532 Elm Street, and it involved off-street parking requirement. Okay.
This is Alan Ziegler. I'm here prepared to move forward with that case, gentlemen.
I could barely understand that. Could you speak?
Mr. Ziegler said he's prepared to move forward with the case.
Okay.
So I should put, you should swear Emily in, and I'll put in some exhibits, and we'll go from there.
Okay. Will you swear in our zoning officer, please?
Do you swear this testimony about to give will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do.
Thank you.
Okay. Mr. Price.
I'll put in exhibit number one, and exhibit one, number one is the notice. Exhibit number two is proof of publication of the notice. Exhibit number three is proof of posting of the notice. Exhibit number four is the application, including all of its attachments. And exhibit number five is the zoning ordinance of the city of Reading as amended.
Okay, thank you. Emily, I know you received some things this afternoon. Have you received everything that you required for this appeal?
Yes. I did provide a revised staff report detailing the information that was submitted today. They are providing one parking space at 317 Church Street. It's a parking lot with a RPA. They are required to have two. And so it would be up to the board on whether or not to approve a variance to allow them to only provide one. The parking is a little closer. It's 317 feet from the subject property. So it's only 17 feet in excess of the 300 foot maximum. And so they would need a variance for that.
Okay. All right. Mr. Price, do you have any questions?
I don't.
Does any member of the board have any questions of Mr. Ziegler? All right, hearing none. Mr. Ziegler, do you have anything you would like to add to your appeal?
Yes, I have witnesses that testified, but I want to provide some information requested at the last hearing. They requested the linear square feet of the pews in the Memorial Church of the Holy Cross. They also requested the number of parking spaces in the parking lot for the Memorial Church of the Holy Cross available for parking. And marked as Exhibit 1, this would be 1, A, B, C, and D, I believe.
Just make it 6. Make it 6, A, B, C, and D.
Thank you. 6A is a March 14, 2024 letter I sent to Jim Goss of the Memorial Church of the Holy Cross, requesting them to provide me with the number of seats or linear feet of pews for use in their church and the site plan showing the existing parking spaces. He did not comply with that. Also marked as 6B is a March 22nd, 2024 letter sent to the Memorial Church of the Holy Cross requesting that they complete a 2-page offsite parking worksheet that was provided to me. I provided it to them. They did not provide it, complete it to me. In that letter, I stated, if you don't provide this information, we may have to subpoena it. Since they didn't provide the information, on April 2nd, 2024, I served them with a subpoena requesting the linear square feet of the pews in the above enumerated church and the number of parking spaces available in the above enumerated church. They were served with the subpoena. They did not respond to it. They did not object to it. They didn't respond to my letter or object to my letter. So the information requested last time, which would have to come from the church, was unable to be secured.
Okay.
Addition to that, I have testimony from witnesses.
That's not quite accurate. We received a letter, which was CC'd to you this past week, that said they have no parking spots for you and that you didn't pay them for the last 2 months, so you lost your parking spots. So
that's not accurate. I paid them. I put their money in the March owed to them in an escrow account because they didn't provide me the information requested. Well, at the time they requested it, April hadn't even come forward yet.
Well, and then let me just ask, how you issued a subpoena if you didn't issue it through the zoning hearing board? That's how subpoenas are issued in zoning matters.
Issued a subpoena through 2024-01 to the city of Reading, to the Records Custodian and Memorial Church of the Holy Cross. That was a subpoena secured from the city of Reading.
Well, that's not how it's done in zoning. You have to go through the zoning hearing board. But why don't you put your testimony on rather than dawdle with this stuff?
Well, I just wanted to show we followed up on what you requested last time.
Okay.
Yeah. That's fine. Just so Mr. Ziegler knows, if you're going to be requesting parking at a different spot, then we don't need the information from the church. So because that letter was also sent to the zoning office. So if they weren't going to provide parking for you at that location, then we're not going to need that information.
Well, I contested their canceling my parking. I'm still parking there. That may be resulting in litigation depending on what is decided here today. But that's beside the point. You can assume I'm still parking there because myself and my staff are.
All right, we're here for 17-foot, de minimis dimensional relief and one variance from a 2-parking thing. So let's not beat this to death.
All right. I have my first witness would be the my realtor, Mark Lowe, L-O-W-E.
All right, will you please raise your right hand? Do you swear the testimony you're about to give will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do.
Thank you.
State your name and business address for the record, please.
Mark Lowe. I work with Century 21 Gold at 925 Berkshire Boulevard, Suite 100, YMSN, PA.
And what's your position with Century 21 Gold?
I'm a realtor.
Are you and your company involved with the marketing of the property at 532 Elm Street, Reading, Berks County, Pennsylvania?
Yes, we are.
Who are the owners of the property at 532 Elm Street, Reading, Berks County, Pennsylvania?
That's Alan and Shirley Ziegler.
I'm going to show you exhibit number two. You guys should have a copy of it. This is a deed dated December 26, 1991.
We'll stipulate that you own the property, that he represents you, and that you're trying to sell it. Let's get to the issue about the parking.
Thank you. I'm going to show you two photographs of the property. They show the front of the property. Do they truly and accurately represent the condition of the front of the property?
They do, yes.
How long has the property been used as a law office?
Based on my determination from the deeds, this property has been used as a law office going back to 1977.
And Mr. Ziegler, you use it from 1991 to the present?
Correct, yes.
Do Mr. and Mrs. Ziegler have off-street parking for the property at 532 Elm Street, Reading, PA?
They do, yeah.
Located where?
At the Church of the Holy Cross on Church Street, Memorial Church of the Holy Cross, located on Church Street.
Did the Memorial Church of the Holy Cross provide notice of two parking spaces for them?
They did, yes.
I'm going to show you should be marked as exhibit. What exhibit would this be, sir? I have another exhibit. I want to get the right number.
Be seven.
Exhibit seven. And this is titled Off-Street Parking Worksheet, signed by a James Gus from the Memorial Church of the Holy Cross.
Yes.
Does that provide for parking for two parking spaces in their lot to the Ziegler, Mr. Ziegler?
It does, yes.
Did the city of Reading, the zoning officer, what did the city of Reading zoning officer do with the request for Mr. Ziegler's request for a zoning permit?
The zoning permit request was denied.
Why did they deny it?
It was denied based on the calculation that the distance from the front door of the property was 26 feet beyond the 300-foot limit to the parking area. The zoning officer measured and came up with 326 feet.
But did you determine that there was not 300 feet, but 500 feet, which is required in this case? What does the zoning ordinance require for commercial parking in that location?
Commercial parking per the section 600-1603 is within 500 feet of the location.
I'm going to show you. This should be marked as in the letter. It's a December 6th letter from Ruth Sassaman, zoning officer. This is denying our request for a zoning permit. Is that already in the record, gentlemen?
Yes, I believe it is.
Mr. Ziegler, I'm confused. The reason we're here is because you wanted to convert the second floor back to a residential use. That's why the 300-foot rule is in effect.
That's not my understanding why we're here. My understanding is that we didn't have enough distance between the parking lot and my office.
Mr. Ziegler, as I explained at the last hearing, parking for your office is not a requirement for zoning in your zoning district. You need to provide parking for your proposed apartment. That is what the variance is for.
Right, and we've explained this to you twice. Last month, we explained it to you. I tried to reiterate it to you. That's why I'm so confused about this. There's no off-street parking requirement in the commercial core district. And that's commercial core, right, Emily?
It's commercial residential, but CC and CR zoning districts do not require parking for non-residential uses. If you have parking, that's great, but it's not a requirement. The variance is for the requirement for the residential parking.
Right.
Well, I can deal with that directly because I have the tenant here to testify. I don't provide parking for the tenant. He provides it for himself, and they have provided off-street parking.
Well, but that's—
And Mr. Ziegler, and as I stated in the last hearing, you shouldn't have a tenant in any dwelling unit. There's no dwelling unit approved for that building, and you would need to provide parking or get a variance.
Right.
Well, they provide parking for themselves, and I thought I had parking with the Memorial Church of the Holy Cross for two spots.
Why are you making this so hard?
I'm trying to find the information.
Mr. Ziegler, let me finish. This is 17 feet dimensional de minimis variance from 300 feet, and it's a variance from two parking spots to one parking spot. That is the issue. If you're prepared to go forward on that, fine. If you want to talk about commercial parking spaces or the fact that your tenant has spaces, not relevant. It has to run with the building. So let's cut to the chase and get to it.
My understanding, just to make the record, is that pursuant to the zoning ordinance, there's a 500 feet required for parking for a non-residential commercial building.
I can read that section.
We're not going to waste any more time on this.
Mr. Ziegler, you put your testimony in.
You put it in on whatever you think is relevant, and then the board will rule on it next month.
Why don't you
let your realtor present the case?
I was going to, but
that's what you should do, because I think he gets it and you don't.
Okay, do you have the photographs for the parking at the Memorial Church of the Holy Cross? Have you reviewed those photographs?
I have, yes.
Let's go through each photograph. And these photographs should be part of the record. One is exhibit, or this be eight? Exhibit eight, sir?
It would be eight.
Exhibit eight, and this would be 8A. What is this photograph of?
That's a photograph from the front of the building at 532 Elm Street back to the alley on Church Street, or that is Church Street.
I'm going to show you a photograph 8B. What is this photograph of?
That's a photo from the alley on Church Street back to the building at 532 Elm Street.
And the right white building there is 532 Elm Street?
Correct, yes.
I'm going to show you exhibit 8C. What is this for photograph of?
That's a photograph from Elm Street facing down Church Street towards the parking lot.
I'm showing you exhibit 8D. What is this a photograph of?
That's a photo of the alleyway on Church Street from the parking lot at the Church of Holy Cross back to Elm Street.
And finally, what is this a photograph of?
That's a photograph of the distance I calculated from the front door of 532 Elm Street to the parking area located off the alley on Church Street.
How much distance does the zoning ordinance, do you understand, require under section 600-1603I1 for non-residential off-street commercial parking?
My understanding is that distance needs to be less than 500 feet.
What did you calculate the distance to be from 532 Elm Street and the parking lot for the Memorial Church of the Holy Cross on both types of calculations?
I calculated the distance twice. The first time I replicated the calculus that the zoning officer used via Google Maps, and I arrived at 288.87 linear feet from the front door of 532 Elm Street to the parking lot. I then used my measuring wheel, which I'm familiar with. As a realtor, I use it with frequency. I arrived at 268 feet from the beginning of the building at 532 Elm Street to the parking lot on Church Street.
Can we agree the distance for parking from the building was less than 500 feet and less than 300 feet?
Correct. Both my calculations were in the twos with respect to the distance.
I have nothing further of this witness. I also have another witness who will testify concerning the present parking arrangement.
And your name, sir, is what again?
My name is Mark Lowe.
Mark, Mr. Lowe. You understand that we're not here about the commercial space. We're here about the residential space, correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so all that testimony regarding the 500 feet is irrelevant to this hearing, correct? Because there's no off-street parking requirement for the law office.
I'm just here as a witness, sir, with respect to what the outcome of these hearings or the nature of them. I really can't speak to that.
And you understand that a letter was issued by the Church of the Holy Cross that there are no longer spaces rented to Mr. Ziegler, but that there is apparently one space somewhere closer to the building that is only 17 feet in excess of the 300-foot residential requirement. Is that correct?
Based on what I've heard today, yes. I understand at this point that a letter has been issued and that the church is no longer offering those spots. I do also understand that there is parking that has been established that is closer than that distance. So I'm not sure if we're asking for a 17-foot relief and a relief from the two-vehicle mandate, or if we're here addressing the fact that the measurements were under 300 feet.
Well, the zoning office has already determined how far it is based upon the way we measure or the way they measure it. So that's the way it's going to go. So,
okay.
So it's 17 feet in excess of the 300 feet, and it's one parking space variance from two parking required. That is what you're looking for in order to sell this building?
That, yes. Yes, sir. That is a critical piece of what we're doing here.
I have no other questions. I just am shocked it took this long to get there.
Okay.
I have one other witness who will be very short and sweet. He's a tenant who can testify to existing parking there.
Well, Mr. Ziegler, again, this is irrelevant because the parking issue has to go with the building. It doesn't matter if your existing tenant has parking. It goes for the future.
We have parking for the building with the occupants, and this is for the tenant who pays for his own parking.
Right, but that's not relevant because as the property owner, you have to provide parking, and it has to run with the land.
We have two parking spaces, I believe we have with the Church of the Memorial Cross.
Okay, well, there's no testimony from the Church of the Memorial Cross that there's parking. In fact, there's a letter that says that there isn't parking. So if you have...
Well, I haven't seen that letter. We have letters that we presented here today that there was parking.
We have them in the zoning file. So go ahead, put on your testimony.
Yes, let's move this along, please. Thank you.
Please raise your right hand. Do you swear this testimony about to give will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
Yes.
Please state your full name and spell it.
William Michalowski Jr., Michalowski Jr.
Where do you reside, Mr. Michalowski?
532 Elm Street, apartment 2, Reading, PA 19601.
Who do you reside there with?
Jennifer Temp Saloon.
Who is your landlord?
Alan and Shirley Ziegler.
Do you own an automobile personally?
No, Jennifer does.
So there's only one automobile between the two of you?
That is correct.
Does the lease for the second floor apartment include a lease for parking your authorized automobile for the leasehold?
No.
Does Jennifer pay for her parking for her automobile outside the lease?
Yes.
Where does Jennifer park her car, if you know?
On a lot on 317 Church Street.
317 Church Street?
Yes, that is correct.
I'm going to show you a parking permit for 317 South 3rd Street. What exhibit would this be, gentlemen? Would this be 9? Thank you. I'm going to show you a parking permit for 317 South 3rd Street. Does this permit her to park at 317 Church Street, Reading, PA?
That is correct.
Who pays for this permit?
Jennifer Temp Saloon.
Do you know how much she pays?
$38.
She pays for her parking outside of the lease agreement with Mr. Ziegler. Is that correct?
That is correct.
I'm sorry. Repeat your question again, please.
She pays for the parking spot outside of the lease agreement with Mr. Ziegler, and his response was, yes, she does. That's all I have.
All right, thank you.
I have no questions.
Any member of the board have any questions?
I have a question.
Go ahead, Emily. You were next.
So, Mr. Ziegler, so that parking permit that you provided to our office with your exhibits, with the vehicle ending in 258, is that your current tenant's parking pass?
Yes.
Okay, so you haven't provided any agreement or lease so for a parking space specifically to run with the property?
By you, you mean me personally?
Yes.
I have not provided a lease permit because I believe that with parking with the church, Memorial Church of the Holy Cross, without problems.
Okay, well, we received a letter to the opposite of that.
So what's the date of that letter, Emily? And we'll put that in as
April 3rd.
And that's a letter from the Church of the, what is it?
Holy Cross, I think.
What's the name of the church, Emily?
One second. Church. Memorial Church of the Holy Cross United Methodist.
All right. So, and that's in the file. And Mr. Ziegler was copied on it, and I was sent it, correct?
Yeah, this was the letter that we got was a copy that has Mr. Ziegler's name and address on it, CC'd Steve Price, and then we were also sent a copy.
Why don't you read the letter into the record, and we'll put that in as exhibit number 10.
Okay. The letter dated April 3rd, 2024 from Memorial Church of the Holy Cross reads as follows. Dear Mr. Ziegler, we have received your request for additional information. At this time, we're unable to fulfill your request for the desired information. Our spots have a waiting list and any future occupants would need to join the queue. Furthermore, you have not paid the rent for the March or April as agreed to on the lease, so your spot has been revoked. Please return your parking passes by April 17th, 2024. If passes are not returned, you will be billed a $20 replacement fee for each pass. Parking in the spot will result in towing at your own cost. Sincerely, James Gus, President of Trustees.
In response to that letter, in addition to them previously providing me a letter, which is an exhibit from James Gus, stating there are two parking spots available, the rental payment is in my IOLTA escrow account because of the dispute and them not providing us with the information we requested concerning the square lineage of the pews and the number of parking spots available. So the money has been paid and is in an IOLTA escrow account. Otherwise, I take issue with that. I contested their letter. If this case goes beyond today, there will be litigation between me and the church, but I'm assuming that we will not have to go beyond today because we've done everything asked of us.
Okay, is that all your evidence?
That's my evidence. I move to admit them.
Your exhibits are admitted. We have exhibits, obviously, 1 through 10 admitted. Is there anybody who, on the board that has any questions of this witness?
No.
Anybody in the audience have any questions for this witness?
¿Alguien en la audiencia tiene pregunta para este testigo? No response.
Okay. With that, we'll close the evidentiary portion of this hearing. And
we'll issue a decision at next month's meeting. You need not be here. It'll be mailed to you.
Thank you for your courtesy.
Okay. The next appeal is 2402-002-521 Elm Street. And is there anybody here representing 521 Elm Street? No. Hearing none. I'm going to make a motion that we deny this application. The zoning office made numerous opportunities to contact them to get the information we needed, and they didn't supply it. So I don't know if somebody has a second to my motion.
I'll make a second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? All right, hearing none, that closes that appeal. Then 2403005, 1116 Perry Street, that's continued to next month. All right, the next matter is Appeal 2403006, 109 Upland Avenue. It is Gernot Burgos is requesting an appeal of the determination by the zoning administrator and seeking a special exception to establish a daycare home on the first floor and a variance for the minimum square footage requirement. The subject property is located in an R2 residential zone district, and the owner of record is Alta Garcia, Polino Garcia.
All right. You want to swear in the interpreter?
Bill? Yes, why don't you?
Do you swear to interpret truthfully and accurately to the best of your ability tonight?
I do. Can Olivo certify Spanish core interpreter? I've been so certified since 2009. And the interpretation of what Phil said is the following. Apelación 2403-0006 para el 109 de la calle de la avenida Upland. Gernot Burgos está solicitando una apelación de la determinación del administrador de zonificación y busca una excepción especial para establecer una guardería de niños en el primer piso y una variación para el requisito de pies cuadrados mínimos exigidos. La propiedad en cuestión está ubicada en el distrito de zonificación residencial R2 y la propietaria registrada es Altagracia Paulino García.
Thank you. Would you swear in our zoning officer, please?
Do you swear the testimony about to give will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do.
Juramento a la oficial de zonificación.
Okay, Mr. Price.
I'll put some exhibits into the record. Exhibit number one is the notice. Exhibit number two is proof of publication of the notice. Exhibit number three is proof of posting of the notice. Exhibit number four is the application, including all of its attachments. And exhibit number five is the zoning ordinance of the city of Reading as amended.
Okay, and I believe Ms. London is representing the applicant, so we'll let her put in her appearance.
Not this one.
I'm the next one.
Okay.
The applicant is on the line.
La aplicante está en la línea. Abre su micrófono, señora. Open your mic, please.
Okay. Buenas noches.
Good evening.
Hello.
Okay.
Will you please raise your right hand?
Levante su mano derecha, por favor.
Do you swear the testimony you're about to give tonight will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
¿Usted jura que la declaración que va a presentar aquí esta noche es la verdad, toda la verdad y nada más que la verdad?
Toda la verdad, lo juro.
Oh, the whole truth, I swear.
Thank you.
Okay. Are you represented by an attorney?
¿Usted está representado por un abogado?
No.
No.
Okay.
All right. Well, why don't I walk her through some stuff?
Sure.
Okay. Voy a detallar algunas cosas entonces.
Okay. Let me just make sure I get the name right. Boraz? How do you spell?
Burgos.
Okay. Right. All right. Ms. Burgos, good evening. My name's Steve Price.
Buenas noches, señora Burgos. Me llamo Steve Price.
Buenas noches.
Good evening.
I'm the solicitor to the zoning hearing board.
Yo soy el procurador del comité de zonificación.
And do you rent it's 109 Upland Avenue?
Y usted alquila 109 de la calle Upland Avenue.
Correcto.
Correct.
And who owns that property?
¿Quién es dueño de esa propiedad?
Altagracia Paulino García.
Altagracia Paulino García.
And your landlord's given you permission to seek this zoning relief?
Y su la propietaria de la propiedad está dándole permiso para pedir esta excepción de zonificación.
Sí.
Yes.
And this is basically a 1,625-foot square foot home, residential home, right?
Y esta es básicamente una casa residencial de 1,625 pies, básicamente.
Correcto.
Correct.
And is this going to be used solely as a daycare, or are you going to live there and then provide services in this home?
¿Y esta se va a usar únicamente para una guardería de niños, o usted va a vivir ahí también y proveer esos servicios en su residencia?
Sí, voy a vivir aquí y proveer los servicios en mi residencia.
Yes, I will live here and provide these services in my residence.
And with whom do you reside?
¿Con quién vive usted?
Mi pareja y mi hijo.
My partner and my son.
Okay. And then how many children and what hours of operation would you request to have at this daycare?
¿Cuántos niños y cuáles horas laborales usted está pidiendo que se le cedan en este caso?
Para un family daycare solamente aceptan de 4 a 6 niños, entonces es lo que yo estoy solicitando, y la hora sería de 6 a 11 de la noche.
6 de la tarde o 6 de la mañana?
6 de la mañana.
Okay. So the family, for a family daycare, it's only allowed 4 to 6 children, which is what I'm requesting, and the hours of operation are from 6 a.m. to 11 p.m.
Okay. And how old is her child?
¿Y qué edad tiene tu niño?
Mi niño, 3. 3 años.
My son, 3 years old.
So that would be included in the children that you would be taking care of.
Y eso se incluiría en la cantidad de niños que usted estaría cuidando.
Correcto.
Correct.
And do you live there now?
¿Y usted vive ahí ahora?
Sí.
Yes.
Have any of your neighbors, after the zoning posting was put out, expressed concerns to you?
Después que se publicó la intención de esta petición por medio del Departamento de Zonificación, ¿alguno de sus vecinos le han expresado alguna preocupación?
No, ninguno.
No, none.
And would you need any employees to help you?
¿Y necesitaría usted algún empleado para que le ayude?
Correcto.
Correct.
How many?
¿Cuántos?
Uno.
One.
And would you provide meals, or would the children bring their own meals with them?
¿Usted va a proveer comidas o los niños van a traer su propia comida?
Yo voy a proveer comida.
I am going to provide meals.
And so while you're preparing the meals, the other employee would be watching the children, correct?
So, mientras usted está preparando las comidas, la otra empleada va a estar cuidando a los niños, ¿verdad?
Correcto.
Correct.
Do you have an outdoor safe play area for the children?
¿Tiene una área afuera segura para jugar los niños?
Tengo una área afuera, pero planeo ya llevar los niños al parque que está al cruzar la calle.
I do have an area outside, but I plan to take the children to a park that's across the street.
How many feet would the park be away from the home?
¿Cuántos pies está el parque alejado de la casa?
No tengo una idea de cuánto sea, pero es cerca.
I don't have an idea of what the distance is, but it is close by.
Could you throw a baseball from the front porch to the park?
¿Pudiera usted tirar una bola de béisbol de su marquesina o balcón de adelante hacia el parque y llegaría?
Sí.
Yes.
Okay, so very close.
Entonces, bien cerca.
Bien cerca.
Very close.
Okay. Has she run a daycare before?
¿Usted ha corrido un daycare antes? ¿Usted ha tenido una guardería de niños antes?
No he tenido una propia, pero sí he trabajado en daycare. Actualmente trabajo en una.
I have not had my own daycare, but I have worked in one, and I currently work in one.
And for how many years?
¿Y por cuántos años?
Tengo 3 años trabajando en daycare.
¿Tres?
3 años.
Mm-hmm. I've been working in daycare for 3 years.
And would the children, I'm looking at the pictures that you supplied, would the children be on the first floor, or would they be in the basement area, or both?
Estoy viendo la foto que usted proveyó. Entonces, ¿los niños estarían en el primer piso, o en el sótano, o ambos?
En el primer piso.
In the first floor.
Okay. I don't have any other questions. Just one question. You know what the name of the park is across the street from you?
Una pregunta más. ¿Sabe cómo se llama el parque que está enfrente suyo?
No, pero si quiero lo puedo buscar de un
rato. DJ Dives.
Oh, okay. I should have known it, but I was
no, no sé, pero puedo buscar. I'm sorry, what was the name of the park?
That, Emily? What was that, Emily?
EJ Dives.
Thank you.
Se llama EJ Dives el parque.
And it is 60 feet away from the front porch.
Y está a 60 pies de distancia de la marquesina o balcón delantero.
The problem is I'm getting old. I don't know if I could throw a baseball 60 feet.
El problema es que me estoy envejeciendo y no sé si puedo tirar un baseball a 60 pies de distancia.
I have a couple of questions.
¿Cuál de preguntas tengo?
Okay.
Where is your helper going to park? And where is going to be the drop-off and pick-up area for the children?
¿Dónde se va a estacionar su asistente? ¿Y dónde va a ser el área donde los niños van a dejarlos y a recogerlos?
Mi asistente puede parquearse, por aquí hay mucho parqueo, ya que la calle no es tan transitada. Igual que los padres pueden dejar y recoger a los niños en cualquier de los parqueos que hay cerca, porque hay muchos.
Okay. My assistant can park on the street nearby anywhere because this is not a very busy street. And same with the parents, they can park and drop off the children at any of the parking areas because it's for the same reason.
Is this house like in the middle of the block or is it on a corner on either end?
¿Esta casa está en el medio de la cuadra o está en una esquina de alguno de los dos lados?
Como en el medio, sí.
It's in the middle, like, yes.
Okay, thank you.
Gracias.
And then one last question. What kind of security arrangements are they going to have? I'm basically saying to make sure that the children get picked up by the right person. Most daycare facilities have either some kind of a card system or something like that. So,
okay, ¿qué clase de sistema de seguridad va a tener la guardería de niños para cuando, lo que quiero decir, cuando vayan a buscar los niños para que la persona que lo va a buscar sea la persona correcta? Hay muchos guardería de niños tienen un sistema de tarjetas o algo así. ¿Qué sistema tiene?
Lo primero es que para los daycares usamos un emergency contact, que ahí los padres escriben los nombres de las personas que pueden recoger al niño.
¿Cómo se llama el sistema, señora?
Emergency contact. Contacto
de okay. So the system that, generally the daycares use is a list of emergency contacts. Where the parents can list who can pick up the children.
Okay. All right. Anybody else on the board have any questions at this time?
¿Alguien más tiene alguna pregunta en este momento del comité?
All right. Does anybody in the audience have any questions of this applicant? In the audience?
¿Alguien en la audiencia tiene alguna pregunta para esta aplicante?
If you have questions, here's what you need to do.
Si tiene pregunta, esto es lo que tiene que hacer.
You need to give us your name and your address so we can make sure that you are people who have standing in that area. And I see some people there. I'm not sure if they want to put some testimony on or not. Muted and they would have to unmute themselves and be sworn in.
Si tiene alguna pregunta, todo lo que tiene que hacer, va a tener que dar su nombre y su dirección para asegurarnos que usted es una persona que es afectada porque vive en esa área. Y veo algunas personas ahí en el auditorio, pero el micrófono está apagado. Tendría que encender el micrófono para que podamos escucharlo.
Okay. Doesn't look like anybody has any interest.
Aparentemente nadie tiene ningún interés.
Emily, do you have anything?
It's in my staff report, but just so it's also on the record, that for an accessory daycare home, the playground area isn't a requirement, but it's definitely a plus that she lives directly across the street from a playground.
Emily, ¿tiene alguna pregunta? No solamente que para una guardería de niños en una casa, no se exige un lugar donde los niños jueguen, pero es algo positivo que ella está cerca de un parque.
Okay. Mr. Price, anything?
Nothing, sir.
Okay, that concludes this appeal. We'll issue a decision at next month's meeting. You need not be present. The decision will be mailed to you, and we thank you for your presentation. Thank you.
Esto concluye esta apelación. Vamos a emitir una decisión para la reunión del próximo mes. Usted no tiene que estar presente, se la va a enviar por correo. Gracias.
Okay, muchas gracias.
Okay, thank you very much.
You're welcome. All right. Now we have appeal 2403-007-0007, 317 Franklin Street. My First Path in Life Child Care Corporation, care of Christina M. Marino, is seeking a special exception to establish a daycare facility on the first floor and modification of parking, or in the alternative, a variance for off-street parking requirement. The property is located in the CC Commercial Core Zoning District, and the owner of record is Batista Investments, LLC. Would you swear in our zoning officer, please?
Do you swear the testimony about to give will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do.
Thank you.
You need an interpreter for this one also, Phil, I believe. And do I remain sworn in, or do you need me to be sworn in again?
Yeah, you should be sworn in again. I forget that.
You swear to interpret truthfully and accurately to the best of your ability tonight.
I do. Can only observe our core interpreter and interpretation of what Phil just said. Apelación 2403-0007 del 317 La Calle Franklin Street. Para la compañía My First Path in Life Child Care Corporación, bajo los cuidados de Yesenia Marrero, está buscando una excepción especial para establecer una guardería en el piso, en el primer piso, y la modificación del estacionamiento, o en su defecto, una variación para los requisitos de estacionamiento fuera de la calle. Okay. La propiedad está ubicada en el distrito de zonificación del Centro Comercial CC. El propietario registrado es Batista Investment LLC.
Thank you. All right, Mr. Price.
So I'll put some exhibits into the record, and I think Ms. London, who's done this a couple hundred times before, will give us an offer of proof. Exhibit number one is the notice. Exhibit number two is proof of publication of the notice. Exhibit number three is proof of posting of the notice. Exhibit number four is the application, including all of its attachments. And exhibit number five is the zoning ordinance of the City of Reading as amended.
Okay, thank you. Ms. London, we'll let you enter your appearance, and then anybody you're going to have testify will swear in at this time. So please proceed.
All right. Entering my appearance for Batista Investments, LLC, Joan E. London, Kozloff Stout, 2640 Westview Drive, Why I'm Missing, 19610. There will be three witnesses. I'll do as much by offer of proof as the board will accept. The first one will be Yesenia Marrero, and she will require an interpreter. Mr. Batista has testified before this board before. He probably will not need an interpreter, and Mr. Masiati will not need the services of the interpreter.
Okay.
Why don't you start with your offer of proof? Maybe we won't need any direct testimony.
Right. All right. Yesenia Marrero, if she were to testify, would testify that if the relief is granted, her intentions are to enter into a lease for the first floor commercial space of the property at 317 Franklin Street for use as a child care center, known as My First Path in Life Child Care Center. She is the managing member of the LLC, My First Path in Life Child Care Center Corporation. The LLC member, the LLC agreement, operating agreement is attached to the application. If this property sounds familiar, it's because we were in front of this board in December, received the decision in January, approving a special exception and variance relief for four apartments on the property, as well as off-street parking. There are 5 off-street spaces, 1 handicapped accessible, 4 which are standard spaces. And Mr. Batista at that time agreed to rent additional spaces at the Reading Parking Authority 4th and Cherry Street Garage. If Mr. Batista were to testify tonight, he would also agree that if the parking variance or modification were not granted for the daycare center, that he would be willing and able to to rent additional spaces at the 4th and Cherry Street parking garage for employees and required off-street parking. To give you more detail about the center, and this is in our application, this will be a state-licensed child care center. The hours of operation would be 6 a.m. through 11 p.m., which is outside of the normal 9-to-5 working hours because to serve individuals on shifts outside of the normal 9-to-5, regular 9-to-5 shifts. She expects that the center will employ approximately 5 employees, with the number of shifts depending on the ages and numbers of children due to state ratio requirements for different ages of children. If Ms. Marrero were asked questions regarding pickup and drop off, there are 5 spaces along Carpenter Street. Mr. Masciotti is here to testify regarding those spaces along Carpenter Street. There are 5 of them available for pickup and drop off. The pickup and drop off is on a street, Carpenter, that has no other residences or businesses adjacent. In that part of the street, it is a secure pickup and curbside drop-off area. For pickup and drop-off, parent would go in, leave the child off, and taking that child in and then leaving, reverse procedure, the child would not to the vehicle in response to anticipated questions regarding security. Ms. Marrero, if necessary, can answer more specific questions about any type of security systems. The ages served will be infants, older and younger toddlers, and older children. And there are separate areas, and the plans are attached to the application. Mr. Masciotti is here to testify to them as needed. There are separate areas for infants, toddlers, and older children. The staff report had some questions regarding the play area. Ms. Marrero would testify to an indoor-outdoor play area. It can be opened or closed. It meets the dimensional requirements in the city zoning ordinance for daycare. It can be opened or closed by means of a garage-type door. It is suitable for large muscle activity as required in 55 PA code 3270.62, meeting the requirements of 65 feet per child for indoor or outdoor play space, and it does not have to be outdoor under the state requirements. 40 square feet per infant, 50 square feet for younger or older toddler or other, and the 65 square feet per younger or older child. This play area would not be used for any other purpose than child care. And other than daytime outdoor play, weather permitting and lighting conditions permitting, the activities of the child care center will take place in the building. So to avoid any noise or other adverse impacts, there should be no traffic impacts. Again, the pull-off spaces for pickup and drop-off are along Carpenter Street. They are not along Franklin Street, and it'll benefit the neighborhood and community because of the need for safe, licensed childcare in areas where people live and work who are parents in need of child care. We're seeking the parking variances, and Mr. Batista is available to testify and would testify that he has the variance as of January 10th, 2024, or the special exception as of January 10th, 2024 for the four apartments. There are only five spaces on the property. There is no room for any additional spaces. He's done nothing to take away off-street parking. Mr. Batista would confirm the lease with Ms. Marrero that if this relief is granted, he would enter into, and would confirm that he would be able to rent more parking spaces. He was told at the time of the rental of spaces for the apartments that are a condition of that relief, that the garage is, 4th and Cherry Street garage has spaces available. And I think that's also been our common experience, that there's plenty of spaces at that garage and others south of Penn Street. Without a parking variance or modification of parking requirements, the commercial space would not be able to be utilized. When he purchased the property, the first floor space was already there. It had been a furniture store in the past, and it also been a seafood market. And I believe that testimony is in the record from the December hearing. And the space has been commercial to the best of anyone's knowledge since the building was established. Most commercial uses, even in the commercial core, would require some additional parking. Again, we believe that childcare is well suited to the space. It would not disrupt the surrounding neighborhood. The surrounding neighborhood is a mixed-use neighborhood, and there are quite a few parents in the immediate area who require childcare and are having trouble during childcare.
Ms. Lundy, let me just ask one question. So there's five spaces, as I remember, on site, four and one disabled spot. Mm-hmm. And your applicant and landowner are saying that they would lease two additional at the 4th and Cherry lot. Is that correct?
Yes, that was for the apartment use. That was a condition attached to the relief in January.
And what, with five employees, what would be the requirement with five employees? How many parking spaces would they need?
Typically, they would need three. However, this is the CC district, so technically they don't have to provide the employee parking.
But would the zoning department be satisfied with those five on site and maybe one or two in the 4th and Cherry?
I mean, we would prefer the on-site parking to be reserved for those residential use that was approved. The only required parking is a designated drop-off area. That's the only real requirement for the daycare. Another option could be if they wanted to designate one of the on-site parking spaces for the drop-off area, and then they would have to then lease an additional one to replace that for the residential use.
What would that mean? That would mean two or three in 4th and Cherry. If they put one on site for drop off,
would need three in total at the 4th and Cherry.
Okay.
And then however many they would like to provide for employees, but again, it's not actually required in this district.
Okay. So I just wanted to clarify that. That makes sense. Mm-hmm. Thank you. You're Sorry, welcome. Ms. London. I'll turn it back to you.
And that's fine. The plan was submitted with the application, and I have Mr. Messiotti available to testify as to any questions as to the plan. Would the board like to hear testimony on the plan, the features of the plan itself?
I have no questions, but members of the board might.
Yeah. Any board members want to review the plans? I don't think any of us do. I mean, they're very clear.
I just have one comment to make.
Yeah.
I must, now that I have the plan zoomed in, I do see the indoor-outdoor play area. So that's a correction to my staff report. Yeah. It does have enough square footage. Now it's just whether or not you would want to grant the variance for it to be an indoor outdoor, not fully outdoor. But at the end of the day, if the state is okay with it, we would be okay with it.
And I would just call your attention to the state regulation that allows the play area to be indoor or outdoor. And there's certainly a preference for the ability to play outside. And the area, and I believe it's shown on the plan, will be a fenced area. So it will be secure as an outdoor play area.
All right.
Good.
I think the only question I have is, and either you can testify to this or you can put somebody on, what are going to be their security arrangements?
All right, why don't I have Ms. Marrero sworn, and I will ask the interpreter to, I'll ask the question, ask the interpreter to interpret, and she can answer you directly.
All right, will you please raise your right hand?
The interpreter? Or...
Oh, did we swear you in yet? I don't remember.
Oh, yes, you did, actually. You did. Yeah. Señora, levante su mano derecha, señora Marrero, por favor.
Do you swear the testimony about to give will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
¿Usted ahora que va a declarar la declaración que va a presentar la verdad, toda la verdad, nada más que la verdad?
Sí, es verdad.
¿Perdón?
Sí, es verdad.
Yes, the truth.
Okay. Ms. Marrero.
Me baja la mano.
Can you, could you please describe for the board safety and security precautions that and measures that the daycare will have in place?
Señora Marrero, ¿puede usted describir para el comité las medidas de seguridad y de precaución que usted va a tener en pie para la guardería de niños?
Estaríamos regidos de acuerdo a las regulaciones del 370.
We would work in accordance with the 270 regulation.
Establecer todas las normas que establecen las regulaciones del
3270. 3270.
La seguridad de cada niño.
The regulations of the 3270 rule regarding the safety of all the children.
What is that?
Cameras. Will they have cameras and card systems and things like that?
Va a tener cámaras y sistema de tarjeta, cosas así.
Exactamente.
Exactly.
Okay. That answers my question. Thank you.
Okay, eso responde mi pregunta. Gracias.
All right. Any board member have any question?
¿Algún miembro del comité tiene alguna pregunta?
Is anybody in the audience have any question?
¿Alguien en la audiencia tiene alguna pregunta?
Okay. All right. Anything else, Emily?
No, just my correction to my staff report that they are providing a play area.
Thank you. Mr. Price?
I have nothing.
Okay. That concludes this appeal. A decision will be made next month, announced at next month's meeting. You need not be here. A decision will be mailed to you, and thank you all for your participation.
Okay, esta concluye esta apelación. Se va a emitir una decisión en la reunión del mes que viene. Se va a enviar por correo también. Usted no tiene que estar aquí. Gracias a todos por su participación.
And we'll see all of you on the second Wednesday of next month.
Nos vemos el segundo miércoles del mes que viene. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Have a good evening.
Thank you. Have a good
right.
evening.
Yeah. All right, Emily, if you just want to let us on for a minute, I guess we have just a couple of little things and then...
Recording stopped.
Yep, 1 second.
All right.
Thanks, Emily.